Well, Cuci, hey, congratulations on your new album that's actually coming out. What is it called? Illusion Motel?
Yes.
So first of all, let's talk about your duo group here, Afrobeta. Tell us who is Afrobeta.
So I would say Afrobeta is a love child born of the Miami music scene. We are an electro-funk duo, born and raised out of Miami, Florida, with a little bit of Cuban flavor mixed in there for some good measure.
So you came out of the music dancing. So when did you actually form this group then with your partner? Was it Smurphio?
Smurphio, yeah. So we've been creating and writing songs since 2006. So it's been a long time.
So you folks is just the two of you. So how did you two first originally met then back in 2006?
We met at a show. Tony was playing with a Latin funk band called Suénalo, and I was playing in another rock, like art rock band called Organic Arma, and we had a mutual friend introduced us at one of his shows, and we just became friends and started talking about music together. And one day I wrote something that I brought to him as a track, and we produced our first songs together. And ever since then, we just wanted to keep writing and playing together. So brought us to this day.
So for you came from a rock background. I've listened to a few songs from Afrobeta here before, and it's very much more electronic funk, like you actually described. So how did you transition from rock to electronic funk?
Well, my heart has always been, I mean, I love dancing. I've been a dancer since I was a kid. And so for me, I just love dance music. I'm a big fan of Bjork and a lot of other Aphex Twin, a lot of like weird dance music that I'm into. So it wasn't much of a stretch for me. I was already playing synthesizer in that rock band. So they had a little bit of a psychedelic edge to them as well. And I know Smurfio also kind of grew up listening to electronic music as well. And a lot of our very first shows were just improvising over electronic beats that he had already created with no lyrics.
So how does the working relationship with Smurfio goes on between you two since 2006? Do you both basically sit down to create the rhythms, to create the sounds, and then create the lyrics together, or one creates the sounds, the other one creates the lyrics? So how did that working relationship works?
It's really interesting. Every song I feel like is its own version of creation. There are songs that I have an idea for lyrically and melodically, and then he helps me kind of flesh that stuff out, and we co-write it together. There are beats that he starts writing on his own, and then I go in and listen to them and start creating a melody and lyrics for. There are songs that he writes the lyrics for and starts writing the beat for, and then I kind of like add to it. So there's this whole different, and I think if you knew us personally, or people who do know us personally, they kind of the same way people when they listen, not to compare us to the Beatles, right? Because that's pretty epic. But people know there's a Paul song, that's a John song. Like people know, like, oh, this is a Cuci song, this is a Smurfio song. Like you can kind of tell in the themes of the songs.
So how why does this relationship work so well in your opinion?
I think we are very different, and he respects what I bring to the table, and I respect what he brings to the table. I mean, ultimately, Tony is incredibly talented. Anybody who would be, lucky enough to work with him could get along with him and write amazing stuff with him. So I feel very lucky to have him as a musical partner. But we're a good balance. He brings the humor. So songs like the Mango song, Chancletazo, Papelazo, like these are his babies. And I have a little bit more of that kind of literary, emotional feel. Everything about the artwork and the stories of some of the, different darker themes and songs are kind of like my creation. So I think it's a good balance of both.
That is a terrific balance. Where do you get your inspiration from?
I love to read. I like to I don't know, I'm inspired by, I'm an, also an actor, so I'm inspired by stories, I'm inspired by film, I'm inspired by my dreams. I have a couple songs that have just come out of, you know, waking up in the morning and remembering, oh my gosh, yeah, I had this dream and I got to put it down and I make it into a song. So yeah, I feel inspired by kind of my surroundings, my environment, my inner environment and my outer environment as well.
So do these lyrics come easy to you when you actually sit down and start writing these songs?
I think I really get inspired by sounds. So a lot of times if I'm writing something to a piece of music that Tony's creating, there's certain sounds that can sound mysterious, for example. So if it sounds mysterious, then a story will emerge that has some kind of mystery to it, or something about something I'm going through at the time. Sometimes a song can be kind of like a cry for help. It's like you're asking somebody or something for help with whatever you're going through, and so you write it in a song and hopefully it helps you get through it.
So what are some of the instruments that you folks use, you know, to create your sounds?
When it comes to the production, Tony uses a synthesizer called the Access Virus. We use Ableton to produce, but most of the songs start right over here on our piano in our house, and you know, we can use acoustic instruments. I mean, we love songwriting, so Tony's rule a lot of the times for most of the songs that we write is that he would like to be able to perform them acoustically as well as electronically, and so they can start anywhere. They can start in the car and on a car ride, or here at the house on the piano.
Wow. So music just comes at any moment, at any time, and in any place for you too. That's
music's kind of like, life is a little bit like a musical. We have a whole album of songs that are just songs to the dogs, for example, that we thought, oh, maybe we'll make like a pet musical or something, because yeah, they might not be Afrobeta songs, but they're fun songs.
and for yourself, what musical instruments do you play? Because I just recall that you do play the synthesizer.
Yeah, I play keys. I started playing piano when I was a really, you know, little girl, playing the classics types of music, but I kind of left that behind a little bit when I started dancing and doing some of the other art forms. And then I just picked up the bass at the end of last year to go on tour with my friend's rock band called Las Nubes. So I learned how to play bass for that. And I play in a Brazilian drum ensemble, you know, I just feel musical all the time. So I pick up whatever I can and just play.
Every musician has multiple talents. This is great. Well, let's talk about your new album, Illusion Motel. Talk about what inspired you guys for this album.
I gotta say, if it wasn't for the pandemic, most likely this album wouldn't have been finished and done, because we had a lot of these songs kind of like almost finished, half done, lingering around. We had released a couple singles last year for the upcoming album, and it was kept being upcoming for a really long time. So this opportunity of not having any performances and being able to focus, we have a home studio here, and being able to just hone in and record at home and finish, I think gave us a lot of focus. So that for me was part of the inspiration, was to create something positive out of a seeming, you know, tragedy, the idea that this terrible virus is, you know, hurting so many of our friends and family and people around us and everybody in the world. So that's like a big inspiration. And just the name Illusion Motel for me is a personal inspiration for the idea that our life here is kind of transient, you know, being on this earth. And so we're going to check in, and at some point we're going to check out. I just got these keychains that are a giveaway for our upcoming album release party. So they are going to have the Illusion Motel giveaway for the first 50 tickets sold. It's pretty cool. Got a little motel keychain there. So yeah, we're leaning into the whole theme of the album for sure.
When is your event, and when is the release of the actual release date of your album?
So the album came out on digital platforms on October 29th.
Okay.
And the vinyl, I should be getting ready to pick up the vinyl by Tuesday. And the release party is going to be the Saturday after Thanksgiving. So it's this upcoming Saturday, the 28th.
Wow, that is exciting. So how many songs in the track, and which one is closest to you?
Well, the album has 13 songs on it, and I think personally right now, I mean, I think it changes. There's just like your moods change. There's, if you're in your house, there's maybe music that you listen to when you want to do exercise, and some music you want to listen to when you're cleaning or when you're, you know, cooking. There's like different songs for different moods. So I think right now I would probably say Warrior, just because that's the mood I'm in right now.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. why Warrior? What kind of tempo is that?
It's kind of a little bit of a reggae tempo. It's a little lean back, laid back. It's raining right now in Miami where we are, and I just feel that kind of a chill vibe of it also speaks to me about like personal empowerment, and so I'm feeling that right now.
Wow. Now you just released a video for I believe your first single out of this album, and
it's gonna be I think now at this point I think it'd be like technically almost a third single, but yeah, it's the one we've released most recently. It's called Chancletazo.
Yeah, I was gonna try to pronounce it, Chancletazo. Yes. I saw the video and you even had the pronunciation, and I was like sitting there watching it. Was that truly the inspiration for it?
Yeah, pretty much. It's part of this whole thing. It's such a cultural thing. I mean, every culture has their thing that happens when you're growing up. And for us, it was this, I don't know how to explain it. It's like a weapon. It's a way to instill order in our house. If you were misbehaving as a kid, you just, this thing was like a tool. You just throw it at you. So yeah.
No, I think that was great. The music video was great. It was very fun to watch. So it was terrific.
Yeah, it was fun. It's fun. It was fun to do.
So tell me about the performance that you do with Smurphio on stage. I saw a few videos because you guys have very lively and creative performances.
Thank you. Yeah, I mean, we love to perform live. It's such a big part of the way we express ourselves as musicians. For a long time, we were, that was the only thing you're doing when you first start out is just playing live. We didn't really start recording until later. So for us, it's the word I'm looking for. I want to be able to say it correctly. It's like a very satisfying part of what we do is to perform.
So how does this, all this creativity actually comes from for your performance? Because it's quite different from other performances I have seen.
I mean, I don't know. It just comes from the music, I guess, and the songs and the story. I mean, I like to engage. I feel still when I watch other artists that I'm, as a fan, I feel music a lot. It really gets me in the heart. So when I play, I feel like I'm kind of getting to do the same thing, so I just try to give that what it makes me feel.
So obviously during times like this, like during the pandemic, you truly do miss being on stage, huh?
Well, weirdly, I feel like it's been a beautiful time of kind of introspection, and I haven't really missed it that much, which is sounds weird, but I'm just accepting every moment for what it is. And I've been very grateful. Like I said, if it wasn't for this, I don't think we would have finished the album. So I know that there was a purpose for this to have to happen, and I'm grateful for it.
And for yourself, were you always musically attuned when you were young, or did that actually came, or the it came later?
No, it definitely came from a very young age. I was always the kid in my family party that was dancing to music and singing, and just, it's just, I don't know. It's got to be something that came from within.
Obviously. Well, let me start wrapping things up with you. We're living in crazy times right now, and obviously you finish an album, but how are you staying sane and keep the creativity inside of you for all these months?
I think the most important way to stay sane and to keep your creativity flowing during these months is to not take things for granted. It's really easy to just think about all the things you can complain about that are going wrong, but myself personally haven't been sick, so I'm very grateful for that. And every morning that I can get up and have a piano in my living room to play, or just sing songs with my friends and do interviews with you and meet people from all around the world. I'm just very grateful for all of that stuff.
Absolutely. I'm grateful to speak with you too. And before one last thing before I let you go, the name Afrobeta, where did that came from?
Good question. So we started doing gigs. We had that song and a song that we wrote together, and we didn't know what to call ourselves because we had to call ourselves something. So we sent an email to about 10 of our friends, and one of our friends in the email wrote that name, and everybody else kind of replied and chimed in that they liked that name, and that's it. We just it was by community name.
The community actually named you. That
Yep.
is terrific. Hey, you know what? I really appreciate this conversation. Hey, congratulations on your new album, Illusion Motel. We should all pick it up because the rhythm, the tone, everything, it's very fun. Thank you for speaking with us.
Thank you. It was my pleasure. Nice to meet you. Take care.
You too.
Bye,
Stay
Gabe.
safe. Bye now.
Bye.